What is up, guys? Dakota here. Welcome back to the Driven Mad channel. So today we are out at Hidden Falls Adventure Park, just outside of Austin, Texas. And in today's video, I thought we'd kind of talk about, I'm gonna have to excuse the wind. We'd talk about what it's like to off-road in a manual Jeep. I get a lot of questions about, you know, is it any different? Are there certain things you have to do? And you do have to treat it a little different than you do when you're normally driving. So I thought it'd be kind of interesting to talk about, and what better place to do it than you know, out here where there's some decent obstacles and some open spaces. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. Okay, guys, so first thing you want to do, obviously when you're going off-road, is put it into low range. Now, Jeep recommends that in the manual you're rolling when you do it, anywhere from 5 miles an hour or slightly under. So what I'll normally do is put it in first gear, get rolling a little bit, put it back in neutral, and then now we're in low range. Okay, so now that we're in low range, now we're in the low range gearbox, so you know, first gear isn't gonna go all the way up to 20 miles an hour. And the clutch is gonna act a little bit differently when you engage it compared to when you're normally driving. So I'll go ahead and show you guys here that in first gear, you don't have to touch the gas at all. All right, so first gear, where it is, I'm gonna slowly take out the clutch. You can see I'm not touching the gas. And look at that, we're rolling and I'm not touching the gas at all. I'm not having to do anything, but as soon as I do, it's a lot more touchy and it's gonna spool up the RPMs very fast. But so at 2500 we're doing 3 miles an hour, so again, it's gonna react a little bit different. Okay, guys, so another thing to keep in mind is that being in low range, you're not always gonna need to start in first gear. You know, you've got so much torque from all that, the gearing down that low range does. So sometimes it's gonna be pointless to start off in first. So I'm gonna show you guys here starting off in second, and I'm not gonna be adding any gas. I'm just gonna start off in second gear and watch how the car takes off. Also, I do want to add real quick, this is not a how to drive a manual video. This is a video kind of showing the differences between driving normally and how you're going to drive it off-road. So if you're watching this, I'm assuming you already know how to drive a manual normally on the road. This is just more catered to what's it like when you're actually out on the trail, hitting some obstacles and all that stuff. Okay, guys, so we're here at this little descent that we got, and just to kind of show you guys what low range does in the manual, I'm gonna leave it in second gear. I'm gonna have it in second gear. I'm not gonna touch the brake or the clutch or the gas and just let it walk its way down, because in low range, that's pretty much what you can do, is just pick a gear, and then depending on what gear you're in, it'll control the descent as you're going down. And then obviously if something gets out of whack, your wheels start to slip, you can add brake as needed, but it just helps the vehicle to maintain its composure as you're going down a hill. Okay, guys, so as you can see here, I'm at a 15 descent grade, second gear, and I'm just gonna take my feet off the brake and the clutch, and it's gonna slowly control its way down. My feet aren't touching anything, as you can see, and we're just gonna make our way down the hill. Now it's leveling out to about 12. So as you can see, you don't always need to be riding the brakes, and it's perfectly controlled if you just use the gearing to walk yourself down a hill. All right, guys, so as you can see right ahead of us, we've got this rocky trail and path that's kind of right here. I don't know how well it'll pick up on camera, but you know, some pretty sizable rocks. Now, normally what you want to do is pick a gear. Now, I happen to know this area fairly well, so I'm fully aware of how it's of what gear I need to use and everything. But normally what you want to do is start off and say maybe like first, and then if it's way too slow and you're, you know, 2000 to 3000 RPM, go ahead and shift into a different gear. And you want something that's going to maintain control, allow you to creep over things. So for this particular section, I'm going to do second gear, and I'm not going to touch the clutch. I'm just going to watch you guys, or have you guys watch how the Jeep reacts in second gear, just kind of tootling along, going over some of these obstacles. So as you guys can see, just putting it in second gear and letting it creep along at about 5 miles an hour or so, just it handles it perfectly fine and does it really well. So even just cruising through this water here, can you do it faster? Absolutely. But for your first time out, you want to get used to everything and how the Jeep reacts. So speed isn't necessarily the key, but in this particular section, you know, you could have done it a little bit faster and make it more exciting. All right, guys, so we just got up to our first fairly decent sized obstacle. And it's actually, if you can tell, it's actually raining, which is gonna make things a bit interesting as far as traction is concerned. So what I'm gonna do for this particular obstacle, I've never done it before, should be pretty easy, but I'm gonna go ahead and do first gear and probably lock the rear diff. And so yeah, I'll let you guys see the obstacle, and then like I said, I'm gonna do first gear, just take my foot off the clutch, nothing fancy, and then just let the Jeep walk itself up. Alright, so this next obstacle is a pretty good one. I'm just gonna put it in first gear, let it roll, and then as you can see, my feet are staying in the same position. I'm not adding any more throttle, I'm just letting the vehicle crawl its way up, not worrying about the clutch at all. Alright, so here's an obstacle that at first didn't go quite as I planned, so I was just in first gear, creeping up with all the diffs locked, and then I get stuck, so I'm gonna push the clutch in, put it in reverse, take it all the way off the clutch again. Once I get set back into first gear, I'm just cruising in first gear all the way up. All right, guys, we're back up here. We're gonna get some food real quick. They got a little grill, American Girl grill. So we're gonna get some food and head back, because unfortunately for me, anytime I go off road, it's always a long drive. I got about four hours to get back. So anyways, just kind of recap here. When you're off roading in a manual, the main thing is don't overthink it. You know, don't worry about how often you gotta use the clutch. Just put it in a gear and just start driving. You know, and obviously understand that everything's gonna be a little bit more touchy. So like in first gear, you know, you don't need to try to mesh the two. Just take your foot off the clutch and it's gonna be totally fine. It's not gonna be always as smooth as when you're on the road. You're not gonna make it as smooth of a transition between each gear. Sometimes it's gonna be a little bit more jerky just because of the torque that gets multiplied from going into low range. So again, guys, it's not as hard as it looks. And once you do it a couple of times, it gets more practice. It genuinely isn't that hard. And main thing to remember is when you're going up something, don't just randomly put in the clutch, or else you're just gonna roll right back and that's gonna throw you off. So just when you're in the gear, just let that gear take you up, add as much gas as you need, and understand that adding that much gas, and I'm sure you guys saw that I barely even move my foot when I'm off-roading. I just barely fluctuates. So anyways, guys, I hope you thought this video was cool, or at least somewhat helpful. And make sure to hit a like if you did like it, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video. Take care.